Hello, dear friends. My name is Sonali Sikdar. I'm a practicing psychologist, psychotherapist, and a life coach in Mumbai. Today, I'm here to share something that is, related to our day-to-day living that we are having today. Especially during this time when we have faced a very different situation, a very life-threatening situation, which we had not faced earlier in the past. One could say that, it was almost like, the entire human race was at war. And there was a point in time when our parents and our elders have probably faced this. But we, the generation that is born after the 1960s or the 70s, I really don't think has really seen such a catastrophic, change that humanity had to face. So what really has happened in this time? There has been a lot of discussion, a lot of information sharing, a lot of things that have been talked about, by various health professionals, by various, psychologists and things like that, where, people have come around and said how you can really take care of yourself and your family, your health, what you need to eat. I think there is an overload of information. It's almost like, after the pandemic, we are facing an infodemic, where we are pumped with information on a day-to-day basis. My simple request to you is devise your own ways and methodologies to deal with your life, because your life is unique to you. Though you may be in the same role, but yet the duties and responsibilities and how a mother looks at life is different in, one mother to another mother. And basically this obviously goes on to say that, the families are different, the upbringings are different. There is a certain way in which you will need to kind of, reconnect with yourself on a day-to-day basis to really cope up and keep up with this, life-threatening situation that is going on today. So my simple request is that if there is any possibility to introduce something called as meditation, which will help you calm down, which will help you become a grounded individual, please do so. Because, with every changing situation, what you face is anxiety. Anxiety of the unknown. It's a basic fear that really, one really comes out with. And it's basically goes on to say that, how you will meditate, we can all devise our own methods of meditation. Meditation is not all about sitting, in a cross-legged position facing the east, or, practicing it in a certain way with a guided music or a guided voice in the background. Find out your own ways to meditate. Many of us love to listen to music while we are chopping vegetables or we are in the, in the kitchen doing something. Many of the people, after they have finished their hard days of work, which is working from home, for many of us, they just like to go in the kitchen and cook a very simple meal, which is therapeutic for them as well. That is meditation for that person. Some person may just want to, count numbers or, take a small walk in the garden nearby, if that's allowed. So devise your own methods of meditating. Do not stick to the, age-old methods of, doing meditations in a certain way. Secondly, the good thing that one can really practice is, as much as possible, try to stay away from the digital world once you have come out of work. Because working from home means you're sitting in front of a laptop all the time, which means after this, you will also have to take care of your eyes, your mind, your stress that you have gone through, facing the whole day's work. So request is try to stay away from, too much of binge watching on the television. Try to switch off your phones if possible. Keep your WhatsApp to minimum if that's a possibility. Have a blackout app, which will kind of not make you go to games and, things which actually get you, attracted towards your phone. So try to digitally detox yourself. That's another way of meditating for yourself. What else is a possibility over here? The kind of books that you will read, the kind of literature that you will involve yourself in, all of that will also be a form of meditation for you. So the request is try to read something which is lighter, which will make you feel a little more happier and much more motivated to go on to your next day of work instead of, something that will bog you down, like, a heavy crime thriller or a heavy autobiography or something like that. If you are keen, indulge yourself in spiritual books and find your own device, devise your own methods rather to do your own meditations, and try to put the best of thoughts, because the good food that you eat makes you your body healthy. The good thoughts that you will put in your head will make you into a better soul.
Help Talks are daily health-related talks held at Health Education Library for People, Mumbai, India. For more information, visit www.healthlibrary.com. Subscribe to Help Talks channel. Be better informed about your health.